Hello guys, welcome to Parsito Physics channel, and in this video we'll discuss about the mechanics question of UPSC Geophysics paper 2021, and almost 14 questions came. And earlier I told you the mechanics syllabus is inside the mathematical physics. So in UPSC syllabus mention the mathematical method in geophysics, and inside it mechanics is there. So let's start it.
First question about that, the particle in kinetic energy equal to gmm by r, then the surface is rotating. So surface of the rotating r, there is kinetic energy is given by half mv square equal to given by gmm by r. Cancel, v equal to root over of 2 gm by r, and this is the escape velocity. So this is will be escape from the earth. It will be escape from the earth. Next is given by the satellite rotating at height the 600 kilometer. Satellite height given, and the radius is also given, and gravitational constant also given, and the earth mass is given, and you have to find the time period. So you know that it from m omega square r plus h equal to g mm. So this will give the gravitational force, centripetal force will be give the gravitational. So if you find that, then omega will replace by 2 pi by t. So if you solve all these calculations, this is the rigorous calculation. So you got the 5.8 into 10 to the power 3 seconds. So you will got C option. So next question is, which one of the following statement regarding the gravitational force is not true? So gravitational force is always attractive. It is also true. So gravitational force is conservative force. It is also conservative force. And gravitational force is long range force. It is also true. So this is not true. It's depend on the medium between the particle. It is not depend on medium. Then next is, a satellite mass m and geosynchronous orbit around the earth, mass m and angular velocity is omega, what is the radius of the geosynchronous orbit? So same earlier it was m omega square r equal to g mm by r square. So same formula you have to find now. R cancel, r cube equal to gm by omega square, 3 is cancel out, then 1 by 3rd. So option C will be answer. So next is the strength of the force. Strength of the strong force is given 1, then relative to strength of the electromagnetic force. So electromagnetic force, it is almost 10 to the power minus 2 of strong. So B option will be correct. And please mention that which force, which is the less, means least strong force. And another thing, that which force acting most shortest distance, which force, and which force have relative strength is smallest. Okay, next question 31. So fundamental force relevant to the geophysical phenomena is our, so geophysical phenomena, whatever we see on earth, so all these things are happening due to gravitational and electromagnetic force. Because the strong force, we can't explain the geophysical phenomena because it is shortest distance, acting on shortest distance. And next 32 question is, the a particle moving under the, so this is the central force problem. Potential is given by, and which is not true. So V equal to minus A by R, then it is force is the conservative force. So momentum also conserved. So the central force momentum is conserved, angular momentum is conserved, not linear momentum, angular momentum will be conserved. Three options, the kinetic energy is not conserved all time, means kinetic energy not, so option B will be correct one. So B will be correct one. And next, a bomb moving with velocity is given by explode into two pieces, M and 4M. After explosion, what would be the velocity of the larger piece? If the small piece moving away, velocity of, so one bomb is split into two pieces, so m and 4m. So m, know the velocity of, it is v, and it is v1, and it is v2. V1 is given, v2 you have to find out. From the linear momentum conservation, mv equal to, m is total mass, m plus m, so 5m, 5mv, and v is given by this one. If you did the all the calculation, you got 45j minus 35 k cap, so you will got it. Momentum conservation, you have to put momentum conservation. This is the sphere, two sphere is given by, and they are separated by 2r distance. So what is the moment of inertia of the system? So of the system, moment of inertia. So inertia of one thing is here given by diameter r. It is not a radius. From parallel axis theorem, if you know that, so moment of inertia about the center of, means about any axis, if axis passes through the center of mass, so I equal to I cm about center of mass plus mr square. So distance between, if there is distance between r. So if you put the all this thing, so you know that moment of inertia of a sphere is 2 by 5 mr square. So r equal to here r by 2. Radius equal to diameter is given m r by 2 square for first sphere, and second sphere 2 by 5 m r by 2 square, and plus that distance between 2 m into 2 r square. So if you put all these things, you will get option A. Next question is that it is given that if wheel is moving in external force, so wheel is rotating in external force, so when will be asking that angular rate of change of angular momentum will be maximum. So rate of change of angular momentum, it is the torque. Torque is maximum when torque equal to, so r cross f torque equal to rf sin theta. Torque will be maximum when sin theta equal to 1, theta equal to 90 degree. So theta equal to 90 degree means tangent, so force should be tangent to the, so this will be force. So D option will be correct, applying F near rim. So you have to be rim, means otherwise in axle R equal to 0. So torque R equal to 0. So near rim of the wheel and the tangent to the rim. So this option is correct, D option will be correct. How does angular momentum of a person change when he spread his arm horizontally? Angular momentum is conserved. I omega equal to constant, and omega equal to change proportional to 1 by I, 1 by moment of inertia. So if he spread arm, I equal to mr square. If he spread arm, so r equal to increase, r will increase, so moment of inertia will increase. So I will increase, omega will decrease. Then the rotation in, so what will be happening angular? So the question is asking about angular momentum. So question is, what does the angular momentum of a person change? Angular momentum is conserved. Okay, so it's remains same. So option will be is the correct. Angular momentum will be same, but if they are asking about speed omega, so then it will decrease because I increase. So next question is about that a light propagating through a glass of refracting index n, and the glass is moving with a uniform velocity, uniform speed v, in the same direction of the beam. So then what is the speed of the light of the glass block as measured by the observer? So one is a glass block is here and it is moving v velocity, and in so light also they are moving in the same direction. So if you put the velocity addition formula, so in speed of light inside the glass will be c by n as the n refractive index. So velocity addition, from velocity addition v plus c by n equal to 1 plus v into c by n by c square. So square will cancel, and if you did all these things, you will get answer D. So next question is, a experiment is designed to measure the length of a rod. Initially the experiment and the rod are raised with respect to laboratory. Consider the following statement in this regard. If the rod start moving parallel to its length, what but the experiment say stay in rest, the measure length would be appear to be reduced to the experimentalist. So this is the length contraction formula. So this is also valid. And if next, if the rod stay in rest, but experimentalist start moving parallel to the measure length of the rod, then length of the rod would appear to be reduced by this. So this is all, means this is the, these two part of the formula of the length contraction. So both statements are correct. So next is the also relativistic problem. Say a observer measure length 100 meter of a spacecraft moving with the velocity, so L is given 100 meter, where c is the speed of light in vacuum. What is the length of a spacecraft measured by a pilot in this same space? Pilot will be measure proper length L0, 100 equal to L0 by gamma, so gamma equal to 1 by root over of 1 minus v square by c square. So v is given by 0.8c. So this question is, I think that the question is wrong, means optional not here. If you did it wrongly, then you will get 60 meter, because means the pilot will always measure the proper length. Na? He is in rest frame with the, that spacecraft. So the proper length will be always greater than the moving plane length. This is the length contraction formula. So moving plane length will be contracted. So please check it. So next is the consider a hollow metallic sphere partially filled with sand. So hollow metallic sphere. So there is a, so then find the center of mass of the sphere partially filled with sand. If we consider only hollow metallic sphere, then its center of mass will be in center. And if you partially fill, then center of mass will be decreased. Means it's come down. So point C is the most suitable one, because point D is too bottom. That's all. So next video we will be discuss about the electromagnetism. Please watch that video also. So thanks for watching this video.